So you want to work in Paris.
Work, 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 work. Hit me on a work, 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 work.
Hey guys, welcome. And if you're new here, I'm Tiff. I'm an American living in Paris, and I'm here to share all about my life abroad and the lessons that I've learned during my time here. So if you saw my last video, you already know that I had been working in Paris for a year and a half, and I was working for a Fortune 500 international company within the beauty industry. So I've had the awesome opportunity to connect with a few of you, and it does sound like a lot of you are either looking to move abroad, you know, looking to move to Paris to work, or looking to move to Paris to study. And I promise you, I have a studying abroad in Paris video coming for you soon. But today I thought it would be fun to share some insight into what it was like finding a job in Paris, you know, the type of work contract and work visa that I was on, along with what it was like to work in Paris, you know, everything from the work benefits to the work culture. You know, I did find that a lot of things were a bit different from what I experienced in the States, and I had worked in both San Francisco and New York. So if you're ready to dive into all things about working in Paris, make sure to first hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and now let's get into it. So I did want to first start off by saying, you know, for those of you who are looking to find a job in Paris, I don't want to sugarcoat this. It can be tough, especially when you're not fluent in the language. Now, there are more and more international companies out here who are actually looking for native English speakers, especially when it comes to marketing and social media. So it is absolutely possible, but it's not always easy and it does take time. So I'm going to share my story with you guys, but did just want to let you know that it can be tough out here, you know, and I didn't want you to use my story as the expectation for finding a job in Paris. I think it really just depends on your situation, you know, the type of job that you're going out for. So please take what I say with a grain of salt. But now jumping into my story. So I did actually start looking for a job while still studying at Essec Business School, which is the MBA program that I did out here in France. And if I'm being completely honest with you guys, that network helped me so much when it came to securing a role in Paris. So I actually saw a job posting online, and through Essex Network, I had the HR contact for that role. And it's funny because it actually took them maybe a month or a month and a half to actually get back to me and set up an interview. And when I had the initial interview, they had told me right away that that role that I wanted to go out for had actually already been filled internally, but they did just want to meet with me to get to know me and keep my file on hand should anything else pop up. And it's crazy because the next week they had told me that they had found a role that they thought I could be a fit for. It was all around managing creative content projects, social media projects, and I was all in. So I had that second meeting with HR, and then I met with the hiring manager, and that was it. And I have heard that in France, it can take a lot longer than that. I think that my process was just expedited a bit because there was an urgent need on the team. But you know, I've heard friends who have gone through like 5 interviews, 10 interviews out here. It can definitely be a process that takes months, so please keep that in mind. But I think one thing that really helped me with this process was first to establish connections, you know, network in the industry that you want to be in. I was very fortunate to have this network at Essec because with my program, we traveled to Dubai, Italy, and Hong Kong. And when I was in Dubai, I actually had the opportunity to meet one-on-one for coffee with someone who was working at the company that I wanted to work for. And she had so many connections in the Paris office, so when I was going out for the job in Paris, you know, she was able to push my resume. And of course, that's not the only reason why I got the job, but it definitely helped. So I do encourage you guys, however you can, before starting your search, to network as much as possible. And also something to keep in mind is that companies out here can be very particular about the school that you come from, especially when it comes to the corporate world. You know, I've also heard that there are companies who even base your salary off of the school that you went to. And just for you to keep in mind, for those who are coming to work out here and want to study abroad out here, the top business schools, and I believe these are still the top business schools in Paris right now, are HEC, INSEAD, and Essec. You know, that doesn't mean that if you didn't go to one of these schools that you won't find a job out here. That's not true at all, but it does help. So definitely keep that in mind if you are looking to move out here. Now moving on to the job itself and the type of work contract that I was on, as well as the type of work visa that I was on. So typically in France, you're either on a CDD contract or a CDI contract. Now a CDD contract is a fixed term contract that's typically renewable up to 18 months. So for example, if you are on a 6-month CDD contract, which is actually what I was on, you can only renew it twice. Now the alternative is a CDI, which basically means that you work for the company indefinitely. Super hard for anyone to end your contract, but it also is a bit less flexible. You know, if you do want to move to another company, you do have to give your previous company 3 months notice. If you can secure a CDI out here, jump on it, because that is honestly best case scenario for a foreigner in France. And I will say, you know, being on a CDD, it is a bit of a risk and it can be stressful at times. You know, for me, every 6 months I was kind of waiting for the company to let me know if it was going to get extended or not. And it can be hard because you can't really plan out your life past these 6-month time blocks, you know, but I did it and I've gained awesome experience from it. But yeah, I have found that it is a bit easier for foreigners to obtain a CDD than a CDI. So now onto the type of visa that I was on. So when you are a student in France, you know, after you graduate, you're allowed to apply for a visa called an APS. And that basically allows you to stay, live in France, and also look for work for up to a year after you graduate. Now, when you find work, this is supposed to be switched into something called a titre de séjour. Now, you can either go to the prefecture, which is, you know, French administration, to have them change it for you, or it can also be done with the help of your company. So in my case, my company did set me up with an immigration lawyer, as well as someone who could come with me to the prefecture to request the change of status to a titre de séjour. And if you do find yourself in the situation where you might have to do it yourself and you only speak English, I do encourage you to bring someone with you who is fluent in French, because more often than not, you know, the French administration don't typically speak English. And it can be kind of tough when it comes to very important things like your visa, which allow you to stay in France. So make sure to take someone with you if you're doing it on your own and not through a company. So now moving on to some of the work benefits that are offered to you when you're working in France. And to be honest with you, compared to the United States, these benefits are on point, but there is a bit of a trade-off because out here in France, the salaries do typically tend to be lower than that in the United States. So also something to keep in mind. But for one, for me, that was a shocker was the amount of paid vacation days you get. So I had about a month of vacation days. And not only that, but the French have a lot of holidays. So I think there are about 10 or 11 holidays a year. So you get that on top of your month of vacation. I was like, now wait a second. And it's honestly the reason why last year I was able to go to Greece, Bali, also go home to see my parents. And also to keep in mind, in August, Paris shuts down, and that applies to the corporate workforce as well. So, you know, my boss usually would take 3 weeks off in August. Colleagues would take at least 2 weeks off in August. So also something to keep in mind. And then another benefit that I thought was pretty nice about working out here was around food. So at my company, you know, the company offered a Ticket Restaurant or Sodexo card, which is essentially a food voucher that allows you to buy food at grocery stores. And also a lot of restaurants in Paris accept it as well. I believe the majority of it is paid for by the company, with a portion also coming out of your salary. But it was also a nice touch. You know, for me, I had 19 euros every day to spend on food alone, which was really nice. And another option that they gave you was to opt into the canteen or cafeteria service. So they would pay the entrance fee for the cafeteria, meaning that your meal would only cost you about 5 euros a day. So those were the two options that they gave us at my company. I do think that the Ticket Restaurant is pretty standard for companies out here. And another thing that was also nice was that half of your transportation costs were covered by the company. So in Paris, if you're commuting every day, you typically have a Navigo card, which is a monthly metro pass out here, and it's around 75 euros. So at my company, you just had to submit your receipt to HR every month, and then you were reimbursed for half of that cost. So that was a pretty nice benefit as well. And something that was nice that my company did, now I'm not sure if this is for all companies in Paris, but they did provide me with French classes. But the catch was you could only take the French lessons during the day, which was tough because, of course, when you have meetings all day and work to do, it's really hard to find the time. But it is a nice little perk that companies sometimes do offer to foreigners who are really looking to learn the language. Another thing that I thought was pretty cool out here is that you are offered a CPF training scheme, which I actually just recently found out. So every year that you work in France, you basically accumulate money into this account, and that money can be used for trainings, language classes. You know, if you're looking to do a career switch, you can use that money for that as well. And I thought that that was really cool. Now you can only use the money towards French establishments, but it's something that I definitely want to take advantage of. You know, sign me up for those French lessons. So lastly, and which is pretty standard in the United States as well, is private healthcare. So of course, when you're working, you can opt into private healthcare. And I think for private healthcare through my company, I was paying maybe 20 or 30 euros a month. But this, it just gives you more coverage, you know, similar to the United States. For example, for me, you know, whenever I would need to get a prescription, everything was free. Like all of the prescriptions were free, which was pretty nice. So that's another kind of nice to have out here when you work in France. So now moving into the work culture. So just so you can kind of understand the team environment I was working in. So when I first joined the team, and actually when I left as well, I was the only African-American, well, actually only American on the team. Everyone else was French, with the exception of someone from Ireland, who I'm actually really good friends with now. Another colleague joined the team who had been working in South Africa, but was originally from Italy. So international company, but very French team environment. So one thing that I noticed off the bat that I think is different from the United States is that out here, they are very laid back when it comes to you having to handle personal tasks. So for example, you know, if you're sick and you have to go to the doctors, or, you know, if you have to go to an apartment visit during the day. They're not as strict, or they don't really question you. They really just let you do what you have to do. And for me, coming from the United States, I did think that this was a bit different, because I do feel like in the US, we kind of have this mentality where it's like, you know, if you're sick, still push through and go to work. Or if you have to call out sick, you know, you kind of feel bad about it, even if you are really sick. Out here, it's not really like that. You know, do what you gotta do, take care of what you need to take care of, and that's it. And then to add on the work culture, I have found that the people are very passionate, at least where I worked. You know, if there was a disagreement, everyone knew that there was a disagreement. They are very passionate and very vocal about how they feel. You know, I just feel like in the United States, it's a bit more hush-hush. You know, if there is a disagreement, you know, we kind of try and find a nice way or friendly way to kind of go about it. I feel like here, they are real. They are real AF, and it's kind of refreshing in a sense. And another point to share is that breaks are important out here. So even for lunch, you know, for example, at my company, we weren't even allowed to eat lunch at our desks. It's like you had to get up, go to the canteen, or go get food from outside. And in the States, I feel like I always ate at my desk. You know, you were always working and eating. You know, out here, they actually take the time to eat lunch, sit with colleagues, converse. So I thought that that was a bit different. Also, when it came to like coffee breaks or smoke breaks, you know, multiple coffee breaks throughout the day. I was even meeting friends for coffee when I could. And I don't think that that's only in the workplace. You know, even in my MBA program, we always had a few breaks throughout the day. And then another thing, which I think is more of advice for you if you are a foreigner looking to move out here, is just please try and learn French. And, you know, I know that coming from me, you know, it's not like I'm fluent in the language, but I say this because even when you are working in an English-speaking environment, there are still a lot of side conversations and jokes that you might miss, or, you know, even just thinking of, you know, after-work celebrations or speeches, you know, sometimes they are all in French if they aren't work-related. And, you know, no one wants to be that person that's like, excuse me, can all of you please switch out of your mother tongue and speak to me in English? Like, no one wants to be that person. And it can be kind of awkward and uncomfortable, so learn as much as you can. And I know that it's easier said than done, you know, even for me. You know, I've been out here, what, 2.5 years now, and it's tough. So try and learn before you're placed into the situation. You know, I'm really grateful to kind of have the time now to dive into all things French, but that's definitely a point of advice I could give you. So that wraps up a few of my points on working in Paris. But what did you guys think? You know, were you surprised by anything? Definitely let me know, and also feel free to reach out if you have any questions at all. So thank you guys so much for watching, and please stay tuned for next week, because I do think that I will be talking about studying abroad in Paris. So thanks guys again, and see you next week.